Hi, my name is John and welcome to Plant Chat. Today we're going to be speaking about different types of cell substrates for different plants in your home. We get this question asked a lot on how to create different types of soil substrates for different plants in your home. So we help teach you how to make them perfectly just for your plants. Today we're going to be making an aroid mix. It's going to be composed of orchid bark, perlite, laca, cocoa peat, charcoal, and sphagnum, and is great for plants that are epiphytes, philodendron, thematophyllum, which is formerly known as philodendron, and plants that enjoy a mix that is nice and well draining, but also likes to have a little bit more of a moisture mix as well. So what is an epiphyte? This right here is an epiphyte. It's called a philodendron revolution, and as you can tell with these aerial roots right here, they actually grow onto other organisms that allow it to climb non-parasitically, but live codependently with each other. Epiphytes like this aroid mix because it's nice and well-draining, but also allows them to retain a little bit more moisture. Aroid mixes are actually a great medium between creating a more drier mix for cactus and succulents like this one right here by adding a little bit more orchid bark, charcoal, and perlite to allow it to be more well-draining. And if you want to add a little bit more cocoa peat and charcoal and sphagnum moss, it'll create a nice moisture mix for calatheas and prairie plants and plants like a little bit more moisture. Why do we create different soil substrates for different plants at home? We want to recreate its most natural habitat in your home so that way they can live prosperously and thrive. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching Plant Chat with BKAT. Thank you.